Hi guys, my name's Ebonee and I'm really excited today because I'm your host of Juiced TV. And if you like fun, you come to the right place because we have an amazing episode for you today. We meet a boy named Blake who loves cricket and shares his passion with some very special guests. David is here to show us how to turn ourselves into amazing caricatures. All aboard the enchanted bus for some magical mayhem with NOMAD and the rainbow unicorn. And because you don't always get it right the first go, we have plenty of funny bloopers from all the kids to put a smile on your dial. How about kicking off some fun with quick questions? We'll get to know each other in no time. On the weekend, I like to go to the park. And at the park, I like to go on the swings. My favourite music is Cruel Summer by Taylor Swift. I listen to it on my iPad. It's a catchy song and it makes me want to dance. My favourite food is pizza and I like barbecue chicken on top. Yummy! If I could go anywhere in the world, I would go to Utah. That's all the way in the United States. I want to go there because there's my favourite YouTube channel and they're called Shot of the Jaegers. And they live in Utah. I'm really looking forward to my birthday. And it's on the 28th of February. I'm going to be 10. Something that makes me happy is all my teddy friends. This is Holly. This is Sally. This little cute one is named Bonnie. Chrysanta, Emerald, Brownie. This teddy bear's name is Valentine because I got her on Valentine's Day. So there's a few fun things about me. But now cricket is calling, so let's head downstairs and meet our friend Blake.
Hi everyone, my name's Blake. I'm excited to join my first time on Juiced TV. Today's gonna be off the charts. Cricket is my thing, I just love the game. I found a chance to celebrate cricket on Juiced TV. I flew down here faster than Brettley bowling at the MCG. So let's go heat things up with our special guest today. Alright everyone, I'm here with Matt and Georgia from the Brisbane Heat.
Hey Blake, hey everyone, we're super excited to be here at the hospital and joining you on Juiced TV.
Thanks for being here and congrats on winning the BBL.
Thank you, Blake. I'm so pumped to bring the trophy here.
It looks amazing.
Yeah, how good does it look with our colours?
Pretty good. I watched the grand final on TV, but how was it?
Oh, Blake, it was amazing. To beat the Sydney Sixers in their own backyard in New South Wales, couldn't have dreamt of a better situation.
Are they going down next year as well?
They're going down for a long time, Blake.
Rightio! And Georgia, you had a great season too. What was your favourite part?
My favourite part was also making the grand final. It was the first time for me to play in that, the big decider. Unfortunately, we didn't come out on top in ours, but yeah, definitely inspired by the boys. So hopefully 2024 will be our year to win that grand final.
Don't worry, you'll get there.
Yeah, hopefully. Fingers crossed.
During the season, your bats have been flogged as hard as they possibly could. Have you snapped one?
I haven't had a dramatic snap of one, but I like to think that you got to have a few cracks in your bat for it to be really going well. So definitely have a few cracks in it. But one of my teammates took it to the next level this year. She was batting with a bat, which had basically the handle had snapped off from the main part of the bat. And she still managed to hit a six with a broken bat. So that was pretty impressive. Look up Grace Harris if you haven't seen it before.
She's box office, there's no doubt about that. There it is, Young. And she's still in it for six. It is extraordinary stuff.
Blake, this is a really great hospital here. How often do you have to come in here?
Maybe once every 5 months. I was born with a condition called cerebral palsy. Basically, all it means is my leg moves differently to other kids. It doesn't stop me from doing anything like cricket, tennis, swimming, motorbike riding, anything madness that I do. And I have this, my leg brace, and I chuck it on when I'm doing nothing. It just basically helps me get around easier.
That's really cool, Blake. But I reckon you can change that colour into a Brisbane Heat colour.
Yeah, you know what? Brisbane Heat's better.
I agree.
Can you tell us a bit more about your favourite nurse?
Craig, definitely. He's the silliest and funniest.
We love a silly nurse. And Craig makes you laugh?
He gets the laughing more. I'd love to know which one of your favourite matches you've been a part of.
It'd definitely be my first game in the Baggy Green in India because I got to play with Dave Warner, Steve Smith and the captain, Paddy Cummins.
Have you ever played with Cameron Green, Marnus Lovett, Shane and Shane Warne? Probably not.
Definitely haven't played with Warner. He's a little bit too old for me, but I've played with Cameron Green and Marnus. They're amazing players. But they're also quite funny. Marnus is one of the funniest people I think I've ever met. Who's your favourite player, Blake?
Matt Kuhnemann, Kalijah, Warner, Smith, Labuschagne. Basically all of the Aussies.
Yeah, I love that.
What's been your favourite match that you've been a part of?
The grand final of our WNCL comp for Queensland. It was the first ever win that we got. So that was pretty cool, down in Victoria, beating the Vics in the final. So that's probably my favourite cricket game that I've been a part of, just being part of that first victory for Queensland, I'd say.
Who's the favourite player you've ever played with?
Ooh, that's a tough one. I think I remember my first year coming into the WBBL, and like I had never really been around that kind of elite cricket setup before, so being able to play with some, you know, kind of big international players. I was playing with Heather Knight, who was the English captain, and Hayley Matthews, who just come off being player of the final in the World Cup. That was all pretty cool. As a wicket keeper, I always used to love watching Sarah Taylor play, and I got to play with her over in England a few years ago in the hundreds. That was a bit of a fangirl moment, which was pretty cool. In terms of the Aussies, got to play with Meg Lenning and Elise Perry, some of the big name Aussies, and being around that setup, which is pretty cool.
There's a lot of kids in hospital that face challenges. What's been yours?
Had to go through a lot of challenges in my career, but probably one of the more recent ones was a bit over a year ago. I was playing in a Big Bash semi-final and took a catch and then went to celebrate, but then ended up completely snapping my Achilles tendon, which kind of connects my left foot to my left leg. So unfortunately I was out of action for most of the rest of that year, so it took me about 8 or 9 months to get back on the field, and that was really hard. I couldn't walk for about 2 months, was in a boot, a bit like yours, for about 3 months, and kind of learning to walk and learning to run again was really hard, and just trying to do my best to get back on the team with my teammates. So yeah, definitely faced a lot of challenges getting back to the elite level from that.
That probably means you spent time in the hospital.
Yeah, it did. I had to come in and I had a kind of a surgery and then stayed in overnight before getting discharged. And you know, it was a bit weird for me because I used to work in a hospital, so being a patient was different. And yeah, it was. But you know, I think something that you can appreciate is all the staff around, everyone trying to make you feel better and make sure that you get off on the right go. So yeah, it was nice kind of being looked after for once, I think.
I've been to the Gabba once. What's your favourite ground?
I've got a few favourite grounds. I really like Adelaide Oval. I think that's really picturesque. Like it a little bit less after we lost our grand final there this year. Also really like Blunston Arena in Hobart. Love AB Field because that's where we play most of our home games here in Brisbane. Went and played over in England for a season and got to play the Oval. I thought that was really cool and we had a really great crowd all throughout, so the atmosphere there was pretty amazing.
I think my favourite ground is the Gabba. I think the crowd, the noise they make there is incredible. But if I had to pick one apart from the Gabba, it'd have to be Lords in London there, the home of cricket.
For me and everyone, can you give us some tips for bowling?
Yeah, I've got a couple of tips for you, Blake. I think for spin bowling, the most important thing is you're trying to spin the ball. And for fast bowling, I think it's accuracy. and also pace, trying to bowl as fast as you can.
How can I bowl without not stopping?
I think maybe shorten up your run-up so you can just keep running through the crease. The run-up's a hard one, but if you nail that, that's where you get all your momentum and all your pace as a fast bowler.
Thanks for coming, it's been special to chat with you.
It's been an absolute pleasure, Blake. We love coming to visit you. How about we get out of here and play some hospital cricket?
Rightio! Shout out to the Brisbane Heat for coming today. And thanks to Juiced TV for bringing smiles to kids in hospital. See you later, everyone.
Well, Blake, that was a smashing segment. Cricket fever is in the air. Now let's see what else we have in store.
Hi, guys. I'm Shalinah and I'm here with David.
Hi, guys. I'm David. Hi, Shalinah. Thanks for having me.
I like to do all kinds of art. I like to do collages and paintings and drawing too. My favourite thing to draw are flowers, dolphins and fishes. And the best thing about art is that there's no mistakes. And that's why I invited Dave here today, because he's a professional artist.
That's right. I've been drawing since I was your age, and one of my favourite things to do is draw caricatures.
I can't even say that word. What is it?
It's actually pronounced caricature. It's a cartoon version of a normal face where you can exaggerate things, make it a big nose, big set of ears, that kind of thing. Basically cartoonifying a face.
I've got to see this. Can you draw me?
Sure I can. Usually I just start off doing a little sketch first, just so I know, just to give me an idea of where I'm going to put everything. So have you ever seen these done before?
No.
Or do you want me to draw a big funny mustache on you? No? What about a little one? No? Not even a little one? How long have you been drawing for?
Since I was 5. Did you watch lots of cartoons when you were a kid?
I did used to watch cartoons a lot when I was a kid. I watched them a lot when I'm an adult too.
How's it looking?
Yeah, it's looking okay. Are you getting nervous? It's nearly finished.
Forget to get my big smile.
How could I miss that big smile? All right, we're just about done. Okay, you ready for your big reveal? All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Bunny. It's like a big, silly version of me.
Yeah, so I just tried to capture your nice, big, pretty eyes and your big smile and your carefree attitude as well with the peace sign.
Okay, David, now it's time for me to do a character of you.
Okay. Make sure you draw my good side.
I'm gonna draw your silly side.
Oh, not my silly side.
Looking pretty good.
You can draw a mustache on me if you like.
And I'll finish it off with your black shot.
The most important part. Oh, wow, it's like looking in a mirror. Well done.
I got your ears, I got your eyes, and I got your double muscles.
Very good.
Thanks for coming here today, David.
That's okay, thanks for having me, and I think you taught me a few good tricks as well. Thanks.
See you later, guys.
See you later.
Some serious artistic talent. Great drawing, guys. It's amazing how art can bring so much joy, especially here at the hospital. Now let's keep the fun going.
Hi guys, I'm Anunta, and today we have some very special guests at the hospital. I'm just wondering where they are.
Hi guys, my name is Mitchell.
I'm Sofia.
Today we're joined by NOMAD and the one and only Rainbow Unicorn.
Ah, perfect. Juiced TV hosts. Now we can get guided through the children's hospital to shoot this TV show for them.
NOMAD, can you tell us a bit more about the show?
Well, we're actually touring around Australia in this big magic bus, performing magic at all the towns for all the people to spread happiness, because we believe that the world needs magic more than ever right now.
What is the best part of being a magician?
Wow, that's an epic question. The best part about being a magician is, well, making people happy. Because I believe that if you can make people happy and give them moments of astonishment, well, the world automatically becomes a better place.
All right, guys, I'm going to ask Rachel the question that we're all thinking about. What is life like touring the country as a rainbow unicorn?
It's lots of fun. We mostly just try to be really silly because people these days take themselves a little too seriously. And sometimes it's just fun to bring out the rainbow unicorn in you.
Hello, Echo.
He's an eclectus from far north Queensland.
Oh, he's a good boy. He's a good boy.
Is Echo a part of your show?
Yeah, we're training him to be a part of the show. He's only 3 years old, so we're just trying to get him used to being on stage and around lights and lots of big sound. So yeah, we're training him to be in the magic show.
NOMAD, what is the best trick you can pull off?
Oh, that's always the best question, I reckon. The best trick that we can pull off? Wow, I'd love to make a real size helicopter appear next to my bus, or maybe even a real-size helicopter appear on the roof of my bus. That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, that would be pretty cool. I think I know the answer, but what's your favourite animal?
Funny you ask, because my favourite animal happens to be a rainbow unicorn, which I can see you got one on your hat, you're dressed for the occasion.
Thanks. Can you be to learn magic, and can you teach us one today?
I was 4 when I learned magic, so yeah, sure. You want to come learn some magic?
Yes, please.
Let's go.
What do you got for us today, NOMAD?
Whoa, Mitchell! Hey, dude, look, I've actually got a coin, and I was going to teach everybody a coin trick. This is what you do, right? You take the coin and you place it in your hand. You have to use your left hand though to come across and pretend grab, okay? So if you pretend grab, it's really not here, it's always here, okay? And you do that by dropping the coin into your hand as you grab. okay? And this can also be done with like a Mentos, a lolly, a little piece of paper that you can scrunch up and roll up. It's totally up to everyone. But this is one of the magical moves in boop, magic land.
All right, Nomad, I gotta give this a try.
Yeah, nice work. We know what magic takes, practice makes perfect. That's it. Hey, but guys, do you want to see something a little bit cooler with the 10 cent piece?
Yes, we do.
Yes. We have the 10 cent piece and of course the $1 coin. Have a look at this. If we go down and we just spin the cup like this, when you go like that, oh, one of the coins literally goes right through the table.
Wow, that's amazing.
Ooh.
All right, Nomad, I see you got a deck of cards. Now show me what you got planned.
Well, don't I have something planned for you, Sophia? Take it out. This is, believe it or not, just a normal deck of cards, okay? Not one of these cards is the same. And they're all there, maybe except a couple. I always give some out, you know? But what did you say your favorite card was?
The Six of Hearts.
Let's see if we can get the Six of... Oh, that's a seven. It's okay, though. If we turn it over and blow on it, guess what? It changes. In your card, the Six of Hearts! Look, watch it really closely, Sophia. It's going to go in, okay? I'm going to push it in. Sleeves are up, okay? In the deck is, of course, your card, the Six of Hearts.
Yeah.
Now, what we're going to do is we're going to turn it over, place it in, square those cards up, spin it around, give it a riffle, and then a click. And guess what happens? Well, it shoots back to the top, just like that.
What? That's so cool.
Yeah. Card tricks are the absolute best. And I've got one that I want to show you that you can teach all your friends and family at school.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yep.
All right, this is what we do. We go through, we spread them out, and you pick anyone you want. Nice work, take it out. I want you to show the camera, everyone at home, don't show me, yeah? I want you to place it in the deck, that's the way. We're gonna cover it up just like this, yeah? Now, if I keep it here, and I use my mind, and I click my fingers, the messages come to me. I know exactly what your card is. All I have to do is flip it over, go through, and literally pull out your card.
You got it.
Hey, would you like me to teach how that works?
Yes, please.
All right, perfect. This is what we've got to do. We'll come over to the table. Now, you always need to choose a key card, okay? But at the beginning, you don't know what that is, all right? And when we spread the cards out, okay, if you point to, say, this card here, which is the 10 of hearts, okay, you as the magician, you have to remember the one that's next to it. Okay, so the card that's next to it, like that, okay? And you can do that while the other person looks at their card, all right? So when they look at theirs, you look at yours as the magician, and then what you do is you place that one back on here, okay? We'll pick that one up and put it back on. There we are. And then we put this on the top. Now, as long as you do a little bit of magic, you click your fingers and you say something like abracadabra, boom, diddly wham, or something, yeah? It adds a little bit of theater to the show. And then you can go through and look for your key card. Okay, so the key card we were looking for was, of course, the King of Diamonds, which is there. And don't pull out the key card. Okay, don't show them that one. Only show them, look, that one is your card. Yeah, and then you can make this bit. And bring it back.
It's on the outside.
She knows that one.
Okay guys, I'm gonna have a go.
Of course. Shh, don't tell anybody. Yes! Perfect! She did it! Woo!
Okay, guys, I have no idea what that is, but hopefully Nomad can explain.
Oh, for sure. No worries, Anunta. You see, I'm a big fan of remote control car things. I think they're amazing. And here, I've got one of my most amazing remote control car items, yeah? Let's get the curtains going up on the count of three. One, two, three. Woohoo! Check that out. Now, watch this, Anunta. This one here, it's gonna work like this.
Okay, that wasn't there a second ago.
You see, one of the coolest things about magic is we can make absolutely anything appear from thin air. That's what we're going to teach Anunta right now. Would you like to learn something?
Yes.
Awesome. Check this out. You pinch out of the air absolute little bits of nothing. You give them a shake and then you boop, make them turn into something.
That's pretty cool.
It's pretty cool, eh? Yeah. Boom,
bing, bing. I gotta know how you did that.
I'd love to show you. Check it out. It's a sponge ball. One of the first ever magic items that I ever come across in the magical world. And my mentor down in Melbourne taught me to make it appear. First, you hide the ball in here, in your hand. You pretend to pinch. And then as you pinch the second time, you pass it across into your hand, making sure you turn this hand over and that one in, yeah? Obviously, without being seen. So you pinch like this, you pinch like this, you pinch like this, you pinch like this, and you make it appear.
Okay, do you mean like this?
Whoa! Exactly like this.
Rach, Nomad, thank you so much for hanging out with us at the hospital.
Our pleasure, Sophia.
See you later, guys.
Wasn't that amazing? Big shout out to Nomad, the Rainbow Unicorn, and all the kids for making this episode even more magical. I've been working on a little magic of my own. Watch as I turn Bonnie into a puppy dog. I mean chicken. Sometimes you don't get it right the first time. And that's why we have so many funny bloopers on the show.
What's up, everybody? Today...
I already messed up.
Another one of my fellow young stars here at the hospital challenged you guys...
Do you want to say hello?
Awkward.
Not under the cube.
What's up, YouTube? I forgot for a sec.
Today I'm at the... I'm looking at the best. I'm both.
It's been a long time since I... I messed it up again!
And here I am at the quills... And here I am at the kids' help.
I saw your amazing... Oh, what?
And happy children's...
I can shrink.
There we go.
I can shrink.
Thanks, Olivia.
I'm Lily Grace.
Oh. What was I going to say?
See you later. Oh,
yeah. I love a good blooper. I've had so much fun being your host today. I'll see you guys next time.